Developing tonight, an attorney representing the family of Audrey Potts says that the Saratoga School District is not telling the truth. Authorities say that Potts, a student at Saratoga High, was sexually assaulted by three teen boys last year. There are also allegations that photographs of that attack were shown around the school, and those incidents led Potts to commit suicide. As Crown 4's Dan Kerman reports tonight, the family's attorney is now alleging a cover-up by the school district.
Prior to Audrey Potts' suicide, what did the Saratoga School District know about the alleged sexual assault, about students allegedly circulating photos of the attack, and of others bullying and harassing her? That's what the Potts family attorney, Robert Allard, wants to know.
The school very clearly has acted the same way that many other institutions have acted when protecting themselves, and I can use comparisons to Penn State, to USA Swimming, to the Catholic Church.
The district has issued this community message indicating, among other things, that prior to the alleged assault, the issue of bullying was never discussed with the family.
Bullying was, without a doubt, discussed with school administrators in the spring of 2012.
The district also says that shortly after Audrey's death, the principal was quoted as saying that, to his knowledge, bullying was not a contributing factor in her suicide. Allard doesn't buy it because he says it was common knowledge the photo of the attack was circulating through the school.
One of the suspects was seen with the cell phone in his hand with three other football players huddled around him, and he was boasting the photo to his football buddies. And one of them said, "Oh my God, that's just not right." And there was an abundance of evidence available to the principal to make the exact opposite determination, and he failed to do that. And we think it was done to mislead and perhaps even to deter further examination into the issue.
The district wouldn't comment on these allegations, but Allard says it's time they did.
Do the right thing, and that's all we want these people to do, is just acknowledge that mistakes were made, acknowledge that things should have been done differently, and acknowledge that if things had been done differently, we'd still have Audrey here today.
Allard says the family deserves to know exactly what the school's role was in this tragic event. He's hoping they'll come forward with some answers. Dan Kerman, Crown 4 News.